Hello, and welcome. After Azahor Plus brought back all the old Citra features that had been removed, like installing CIA files from various sources and support for the 0.3 DS format, the same developer now launches ShadPS 4 Plus, which restores the ability to install PKG files. This feature had previously been removed with the justification of fighting piracy, though the decision was quite controversial. If you want to buy original games while saving a lot, check out Instant Gaming, the digital store that sells games for various platforms, such as PC, PlayStation, Xbox, and Nintendo Switch. Get games of all genres with discounts of up to 95%. You'll also find a variety of gift cards and credits for other services. You can pay for your order through your credit card on a website with a 4.7 rating on Trustpilot. You're buying games directly from Instant Gaming, not from other retailers. If you encounter any issues, Instant Gaming offers 24/7 support. And this month, Instant Gaming is offering a great discount on the newly released Monster Hunter Wilds, with up to 51% off, ensuring the lowest historical price for the game. Check out the price comparison with Steam's pricing. What are you waiting for to save? Links in the description. Before we get into the video, don't forget to leave a like to support the channel. And if this is your first time here, consider subscribing to stay updated with all the news. Starting with Azahor Plus, I already shared more details in the video linked in the card, but today let's focus only on the outcome of that situation. After Pablo MK7 insisted that the name and logo Azahor were his property, and others argued that since it's an open source project he couldn't make that claim, a debate began over whether the new fork was required to change its name and visual identity. There was even talk of a DMCA notice, which was quickly dismissed by the Azahor Plus developer. However, last week there was a small change. The name remained the same, but the logo was changed. Everything else about the project stayed the same. Every time a new Azahor build is released, the Plus version is usually updated shortly after, only replacing the executable. In previous tests, Azahor Plus showed up to a 10% performance gain compared to the original fork. Some people even joked that Azahor looked like the de novo of emulators, since some of the features added to the official version slightly reduced performance. As I've mentioned in other videos, I personally don't see the point in applying those kinds of restrictions to a console that can already be considered abandonware. Besides, since some fan-translated games simply don't work on Azahor, even after converting them to the CCI format, I preferred to continue using Azahor Plus, which kept support for those titles. Not to mention the time saved by avoiding file conversions or re-downloading corrupted dumps. Of course, that doesn't mean the original Azahor has no value, since the Plus version just uses the main project as a base and reintroduces removed features. So if you like Azahor Plus and want to keep taking advantage of its features, it's important to support both projects. Now talking about ShadPS 4, even though the context is a bit different, there are a lot of similarities. The original team removed the PKG installation feature, which is the most common format found for backups online, claiming that the feature encouraged piracy. Their proposed solution was to use a jailbroken PlayStation 4 to copy games over the network. But here's the thing, isn't using a jailbroken console also considered piracy? There are ways to dump PKG files directly to the emulator folder, but they require external tools and steps outside the emulator itself. The main difference compared to the 3DS is that the PS4 is still an active console. If we only consider home consoles, excluding the hybrid Switch, it's the best-selling one of the current generation. Sony still hasn't built a strong base on the PlayStation 5, partly because of a lack of new releases and a heavy focus on remasters. So maybe the ShadPS 4 team had valid reasons to make that decision. It's possible that decrypting PKG files involves some Sony patent. I'm not sure, but I'm sure they know more about that than we do. Still, knowing that this restriction annoyed a lot of people, the Azahor Plus team decided to act once again, creating an executable that, when replacing the original, reactivates the PKG installation feature directly in the emulator. This is still a recent addition, less than a week old, and so far, the ShadPS 4 team hasn't responded or taken any action against it. The development of the Plus version continues normally and without issues. It's worth remembering that this isn't the only solution available. Before I even knew about the Plus version, I had duplicated my emulator folder, disabled updates, and kept an older version just to install the games. After that, I used the most recent version to play with better performance and accuracy. That's also a valid alternative. Once again, it's important to keep in mind that ShadPS 4 Plus doesn't develop anything by itself. All progress in the emulator comes from the original ShadPS 4. The Plus version only brings back what was removed. So if you support the project, consider supporting both sides. If you want to check out any of these projects, I'll leave all the links in the description, including the one shared by AlexandX, where you'll find direct access to all these versions. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.